Hi everyone, this is Aki with another Google Sheets video. We're going to go over how to use conditional formatting in your sheet to highlight a whole row or column to show intersection of the two. So I have an example here with US gas prices, and I have data going from 1978 as rows till 2022, and then across I have monthly data from January to December to column M. So whenever I select a year here, it highlights, the conditional formatting highlights that row for the year, and then if I change the month, it highlights that column. So I know that the intersection of this should be what my index plus match and VLOOKUP formulas show me is the gas price. What was the gas price for that time? So for 2020 August, that was the gas price, and I can quickly check. And this is a quick way of quickly seeing where the data is, because it's just easier to see it when you see the intersection of the columns versus if you don't have any conditional formatting. And I'll show you that in a second. So the way to access conditional formatting is you have to select somewhere in your range what you will specify, go to format, conditional formatting, and right now it's showing me what I have in this area as to my formulas. Now if I just remove these, because I'm going to show you from the beginning how to use it, you can see right away how difficult it is to read this data. Like, I kind of have to look where's 2013 and scroll through that and just kind of go across the screen. Hopefully I'm reading the right numbers, just so many numbers and they're all similar. So it's just the conditional formatting makes this referencing much easier, and it's just like a cool way of presenting the data where things are being looked up. Let me click on the conditional formatting one more time, format, conditional formatting, and now here is just referencing where my cursor was, so I can specify a range. It's just referring to a cell, but I want to specify a range, so I click select data range, and here I'm going to specify the entire range from A to year, where I have label for year, and then go across the months and then scroll down to the end of my table to 1978 data and click OK. Now if I just leave it like this, what is it doing? Basically it's saying anytime you have not an empty cell, highlight it. So that's not what I want. I can select this and scroll down to the bottom to custom formula is. And here I'm going to create my formula. So right now I want to highlight the row for the year. So the row, where is my year? In column A, I want to select, find that year and highlight that entire row. So I'm going to put equal, where is my year? The year is in column A. So I'm going to say A, and you want to select the first cell for your range. So I'm going to say A2. Now it's still highlighting everything right now. But we will make the change. I'll show you why. Right now I want to see a year that's equal what? I want to say equal the year selected. But if I click on this, nothing is happening. It doesn't really copy it over to my conditional formatting. So you actually have to type in the formula. So it's Q and the row it's 9. Q9. Now it's still not highlighting everything. You actually have to make an absolute reference for the column, because you want to, here we have a specified range, so you want to tell the conditional formatting that the column, it's always going to be just the column A. So you want to put absolute reference with an A like this. Then additionally, you also want to put absolute reference for the cell that we're going to be referencing. And once you do that, now you can see right away the row for 2013 is highlighted. Let me click done and let's test it out. Let's test another year. Yep, it's referencing. Now, one way where you can see an issue, if you click on this, often if your range starts a different row or column than what you're specifying here at the beginning as your absolute, that will make a difference. Let me show you. For example, if I say A3, start from this row instead of from the beginning of my range, If I change that, look what happened. It's actually moving up one because the reference is different than the range. So you want to make sure that the reference for your column it starts at the same point as your range. So I'm going to go back to 2 to make it correction and click done. Now we're going to do the same thing for column. Now we want to highlight the column for the month that specifies. So I'm going to say add another rule, specify the range. I'm going to select the same range. We don't want to make any confusing selections here, so we're selecting the same thing as we did before. Click OK. Now we want to go also to custom formula, and in this case we want to say equal, and here we want to reference the months, and the months will be in row 2. So now I'm going to start still from A2. So I'm going to say A2 and I'm going to say equal, and now it has to be equal to Q10. So Q10, nothing is happening, right? So we want to make sure now what's absolute. Absolute is the row 2. We want to make sure it's always row 2 because our range is wide. And what we want to also make an absolute, the reference cell that we're talking about. And now we have it like this. You see, you can see right away for August is highlighted. Again, if you select it from B, let's say, to, it will be selecting different wrong month. So you want to make sure the reference column and cell is the same as the beginning of your range. Click done. And now let's test it out for the month, May, October, and then year. So here we go. This works. And so it matches, and you can see that at the intersection of the column and row is my gasoline price. And it's just an easy way of referencing and showing your viewer your data point. So thanks so much for watching.